scourging at the pillar. The people said, "Let his blood be upon us and upon our children." At that, he released Barabbas to them. Jesus, however, he first was scourged.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven.
Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Amen.
O Mary, conceived without sin,
pray for us who have recourse to you.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death.
Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee.
Pray
for us who have recourse to you.
Hail Mary, full of grace.
himself went out to what is called the place of the skull. There they crucified him.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven.
Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Amen. O Mary, conceived without sin, pray for us who are born to you. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and in the hour of death. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and in the hour of death. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen.
O my Jesus, forgive us our sins, save us from the fires of hell, and lead all souls to heaven, especially those who are in most need of thy mercy.
The fifth of the sorrowful mysteries is the crucifixion and death of our Lord. The curtain in the sanctuary was torn in two. Jesus uttered a loud cry and said, Father, into your hands I commend my spirit. After this he expired. Our Father who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven.
Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
O Mary, conceived without sin,
pray for us who have recourse to thee.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
O my Jesus, forgive us our sins, and save us from the fires of hell, lead all souls to heaven, especially those who have need of thy mercy. Hail, Holy Queen,
Mother of Mercy, our life, our sweetness, and our hope. To thee we cry, who banish shield to thee. To thee we send about our sorrows, mourning, and weeping, and this valley of tears. Turn the most gracious advocate, thine eyes of mercy towards us, and after this our exile, show unto us the blessed fruit of thy womb, Jesus. O clement, O loving, and sweet Virgin Mary,
pray for us, O Holy Mother of God,
that we may be made worthy of the promises of Christ.
Let us pray. O God,
whose only begotten Son, by his life, death, and resurrection, has purchased for us the rewards of eternal life, grant we beseech thee that while meditating upon these mysteries in the most holy virtue of the Blessed Virgin Mary, we may imitate what they contain and obtain what they promise, through the same Christ our Lord. Amen.
May the divine assistance remain always with us.
And may the souls of the faithful depart, and through the mercy of God, rest in peace. Amen.
The Memorare.
Remember, O most gracious Virgin Mary, that never was it known that anyone who fled thy protection, implored thy help, or sought thy intercession, was left unaided. Inspired by this confidence, I fly unto you, O Virgin of Virgins, my mother. To thee do I come, before thee I stand, sinful and sorrowful. O Mother of the Word incarnate, despise not my petitions, but in thy mercy hear and answer me. Amen.
Please join me for Hail Mary, our Father, and the glory be. We have a hurricane be hitting the coast. We hope that there's not so much damage and you are making more trees knocked down. Pray for Father Dan that he has a safe vacation. And we also want to pray that we have holy officials elected in our next election. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee.
Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Our Father,
who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Amen.
Glory
be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen.
I have a few announcements to make. On election day, Tuesday is the week from today, the 3rd. There will be an all-day adoration of the Blessed Sacrament. And we'll begin at 6 o'clock in the morning until 8 o'clock p.m. Please contact the office if you're interested in spending an hour with our Lord. Halloween night. Please contact Deacon Vicente if you're interested in adoring. And our officiators, Father Jude Halpen, celebrant for today. Mass intention is being offered today for David Morehouse, Joe Pelofigu, Fan Zan Nam, Nugent, and Maria Marion. Also, we're praying for priests and seminarians. That would be the Reverend Dustin Dowd and Caleb Henry. Please stand for the angels. The angel of the Lord declared unto Mary, Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Behold, the handmaid of the Lord. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
And the Word was made flesh
and dwelt among us.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Pray for us, O Holy Mother of God,
that we may make worthy of the promises of Christ.
Let us pray. Pour forth, we beseech thee, O Lord, thy grace into our hearts, that we to whom the incarnation of Christ, thy Son, was made known by the message of an angel, may by his passion and cross be brought to the glory of his resurrection through the same Christ our Lord.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Grace to you in peace from God our Father and the Lord Jesus Christ.
And with your spirit.
Brethren, let us take a few moments and call to mind our sins, asking the Lord for his pardon and his peace. I confess to Almighty God,
and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have ever sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and what I have failed to do, through my most grievous fault. Therefore, I ask the Blessed Mary, the Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me and to Lord our God.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Let us pray. Almighty, O living God, increase our faith, hope, and charity, and make us love what you command, so that we may merit what you promise. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Ephesians. Brothers and sisters, be subordinate to one another out of reverence for Christ. Wives should be subordinate to their husbands as to the Lord, for the husband is head of the wife, just as Christ is head of the church. He himself the Savior of the body. As the church is subordinate to Christ, so wives should be subordinate to their husbands in everything. Husbands, love your wives, even as Christ loved the church and handed himself over for her to sanctify her, cleansing her by the bath of the water with the word, that he might present to himself the church in splendor, without spot or wrinkle or any such thing, that she might be holy and without blemish. So also husbands should love their wives as their own bodies. He who loves his wife loves himself. For no one hates his own flesh, but rather nourishes and cherishes it, even as Christ does the church, because we are members of this body. For this reason, a man shall leave his father and his mother and be joined to his wife, and the two shall become one flesh. This is a great mystery, but I speak in reference to Christ and the church. In any case, each one of you should love his wife as himself, and the wife should respect her husband. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Blessed are those who fear the Lord.
Blessed are those who fear the Lord.
Blessed are you who fear the Lord, who walk in his ways, for you shall eat the fruit of your handiwork. Blessed shall be you be in favor. Blessed are those who fear the Lord. Your wife shall be like a fruitful vine in the recesses of your home, your children like olive plants around your table.
Blessed are those who fear the Lord.
Behold, thus is the man blessed who fears the Lord. The Lord bless you from Zion. May you see the prosperity of Jerusalem all the days of your life.
Blessed are those who fear the Lord.
The Lord be with you.
With
a reading from the Holy Gospel according to Luke. Jesus said, "What is the kingdom of God like? To what can I compare it? It is like a mustard seed that a man took and planted in the garden. When it was fully grown, it became a large bush, and the birds of the sky dwelt in its branches. Again he said, to what shall I compare the kingdom of God? It is like yeast that a woman took and mixed with 3 measures of wheat flour until the whole batch of dough was leavened. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, amen. Father, on the day of our wedding, I would like to read, as the second reading, Ephesians 5:21-33, that has been said by no bride ever in the history of the church. But may I suggest to you that the reason why it wasn't said is because there's a profound understanding of what that passage means. So I would like to take just a look at it, because when you first hear it, you may get the false assumption that it's about authority, and it's not. Here's what I mean by that. So God does indeed place the man, the husband, in charge of the family. So, is he an authority? Yes, I guess. But you know, if you continue reading this passage of scripture, it becomes quite clear that he's not only a man in authority, that he's a man under authority. Whose authority? God's authority. So he doesn't have license to do whatever he wants to his wife and to his children. What he does have the right and the privilege to do is to bring Christ into the marriage and into the family. He is charged, in essence, with being for his wife and family an other Christus, another Christ. Because Paul challenges him to love his wife and his family as Christ loves the church. Gentlemen, think about that long and hard. Think about that. Because out of love for the church, Jesus went to the cross. Such profound love did Christ have for the church that he was willing to open his arms on the wood of the cross and sacrifice himself out of love for his people. So listen to what this is saying, gentlemen. Listen to what this is saying. It's saying that if you desire to be as Christ has mandated, that you be the head of your family, if you truly desire to do that and to be that, recognizing that you are not only a person in authority but under authority, if that's the case, then you better look good on wood. Because that's where you're going. You're going to the cross. You're going to the cross time and time and time again. Out of love, first for your spouse, and then for your children. You see, the type of authority that God is speaking about here, through Paul, is a sacrificial authority. It empties
yourself out for other people. It's not about power. It's not about authority. It's about sacrifice. The nature of what Paul is talking about is sacrifice. And you must be willing, day in, day out, to offer yourself on the cross daily out of love for your wife and your family. Now, I don't want to turn this into a marriage preparation class, as tempted as I may be. Okay, but gentlemen, if you're listening to this, and ladies, if you're listening to this, and you're understanding what I'm talking about, then how could you not desire to be obedient to your husband? If he's emptying himself out, and that there is nothing more important in his mind than how he may serve his wife and his children. If that's the case, if he truly has your best interest at heart, then pray God, tell me, why wouldn't you follow him? Why wouldn't you? If that was the case. You see, do you see why this is so confused by people today? They think it's about power. When they hear the word authority, they think power. And it's so not. Because in this vein, the authority that Paul is talking about is not power, but sacrifice. Sacrifice. It's a sacrificial authority. So here's my challenge. All you married men in the congregation today, go home and do this to your wife and family. Go home and be this. And women and wives, allow them the opportunity to become this. And then watch. Watch how this transforms. First your marriage, and then your family. May our God be blessed.
Amen.
Let us stand now and offer our prayers and petitions for all those who have dedicated themselves to God, that the Lord help them to be faithful to their promise. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For our president and all government leaders and all those that have been called to lead and serve, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For all those who are sick and suffering, that they may one day feel the healing hand of God in their lives, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For all those who have died, especially those who will die this day, that the Lord in his love and mercy may open for them the gates of eternal life, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
Lord our God, hear the prayers that your people offer with all of their hearts, and never abandon the people who share your life. This we ask through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Blessed are you, Lord, God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the bread that we offer you, which earth is given and human hands have made. It will become for us the bread of life. By the mingling of this water and wine, may we come to share in the divinity of Christ, who humbled himself to share in our humanity. Blessed are you, Lord, God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the wine that we offer. Fruit of the vine and work of human hands, it will become for us our spiritual drink. With humble spirit and contrite heart, may we be accepted by you, O Lord, and may our sacrifice in your sight this day be pleasing to you, Lord God. Pray, brethren, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God the Almighty Father. Look, we pray, O Lord, on the offerings we make to your majesty, that whatever is done by us in your service may be directed above all to your glory through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your heart.
And lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. His death we celebrate in love, his resurrection we confess with living faith, and his coming in glory we await with unwavering hope. And so, with all the angels and saints, we praise you, as without end, we acclaim.
Holy, 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 Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and the blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. For at the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do in memory of me." The mystery of faith. Save us, Savior of the world, for by your cross and resurrection you have set us free. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and Douglas, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, the Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. For it is through him, and with him, and in him, O God, almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. At the Savior's command, formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father,
who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us
as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom of God and the glory of God.
Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who lives and reigns forever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you all.
And with your spirit.
Lamb of God,
you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us.
Ecce Agnosti. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those who are called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy.
To my heart, I embrace you as if you permit me to be separated from you.
Let us pray. May your sacraments, O Lord, we pray, perfect in us what lies within them, that what we now celebrate in signs we may one day propose in truth, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And may Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. The Mass is ended. Let us go in peace to love and to serve the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Saint Michael the Archangel,
in this time, be our peace.